All right, Shalom, Yah Shirala, back at it again with another Lord with an edifying video through the spirit and the power of Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah Bahashem, Rechakwadash. Before I go any further, I want to give all honor and all glory and all praises to our Heavenly Father and to His only begotten Son, Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah Bahashem, Rechakwadash. And next up, double honors to our apostles and our elders of Great Millstone, who still guard us to the highways and byways and feed us with 100% truth according to the Bible and Heruel. And Shalom, Labacharyam, Wabarakiam, Shoyah Shirala, which is peace and blessings to the elect of the nation of Israel and the Lashon Kodesh, the Hebrew tongue. And pretty much, man, this lesson is going to be going into how the 2/3 of our people are blinded from the truth, man. You know? And who is responsible for that? Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah using the Esau Edom, the so-called white man, you know? So without further ado, we're going to start off with the book of Romans, the 11th chapter. Let's see here. This is the book of Romans, chapter 11, verse 7. This is the book of Romans, chapter 11, verse 7. This is the Apostle Paul talking to the Israelites that was in Rome, right? What then? Israel have not attained that which ye seek for? Now, Israel is a people before us a place, man. It's talking about the descendants of Jacob, you know, whose name was changed to Israel after he wrestled the angel, man. So it's referring to the Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native American Indians, and also you Israelite foreigners, according to the CDO fathers, man, you know? Romans 11 verse 7 again. What then? Israel had not attained that which he seeketh for. And what is our people seeking? Our people are seeking for the truth, you know. For an example, Ice Cube, man, he's wondering why all these things are happening to our people, you know what I'm saying? But hey, man, hey, it's all in the scriptures, man, you know. But our people are not going to sacrifice their lives and freedom to come and serve Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah, you know, under the umbrella of Great Millstone, man, and the other camps that's affiliated with Great Millstone. They're not going to do that because they've received their consolation on this side. Talk about our celebrities, you know. And it reads, but the election have obtained it, and the rest were blinded. As I can see, the election have obtained it, the elect, you know, which the Lord's willing will be a part of the elect. You know, the Lord has called us into this truth. Lord's willing to be chosen to be delivered out of this captivity, or even die for the name of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah and be martyrs, man. You know, either way, we're still going to receive that great reward from the Lord, man, which we're hoping we be those men. And it says, and the rest were blinded, meaning 2/3 of our people can't understand this truth. 2/3 of our people can't understand, start off with the head apostles, the elders of Great Millstone, or why we go out during the highways and hedges, in season, out of season, whether it's hot, whether it's warm, or whether it's cold, or whether it's cool, man, to teach the word, man. You know why? Because they've been blinded by the Lord, man. You know? And when you're blind, you can't see. You know? You're in a pretty much in a confused state. You know? Just as you see on this screen, man. If that man on the screen start walking around trying to go to a specific destination, he's going to go everywhere, man. You know? Why? Because he can't see. So, let's go to the book of Isaiah, the 29th chapter, right? This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 29, verse 9, starting at verse 9. Stay yourselves and wonder, cry out and cry, for they are drunk, but not with wine. They stagger, but not with strong drink. Meaning, when it says that they're drunk, but not with wine, meaning they're drunk off those philosophies, man. You know, of that plantation of Christianity, these other different false religions, man. You got these other Israelite groups out here teaching false doctrine. You know, they're drunk spiritually, man. They're spiritually intoxicated, right? And it reads verse 10, for the Lord have poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep. Exactly. See, Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah, who the word even calls God and Jesus Christ, have poured this spirit upon our people, man, to be blinded, man, for understanding and receiving the truth out of sincerity of heart. And it reads, and have closed your eyes. See, now when you close your eyes, You can't see anything, man. So that's what the Lord did to our people spiritually. And it reads, the prophets and your rulers, the seers, have you covered. Exactly. Your teachers, you know what I'm saying? These so-called leaders out here, man, the Lord's not dealing with them, man. That's why they bugged out, man. They teach a false doctrine. You know what I'm saying? You got these wacky, tacky Christian leaders, such as T.D. Jakes, Joel Osteen. You know what I'm saying? You got these other Israelite groups out here teaching the false doctrine. You know who you is. You know what I'm saying? The Lord has blinded your eyes, man. You know? Even when you know the truth and you're not teaching the truth, the Lord still blinded you. You know? So, let me see. This is the book of Romans chapter 1, verse 28. Even as they did not like to retain the Most High in their knowledge, the Most High gave them over to a reprobate mind. Exactly, see? And a reprobate, when you look at that definition, man, it's not a good word, man. You know, I think one of the definitions of a reprobate is a person with bad morals and characteristics, which is a.k.a. a two-third, man, a nigga, you know? And who gave him that spirit? Yahweh about Shem Yahushai, man. And the word mind, go back to the Hebrew word law, which meaning your mind, man. It's like, you know, hey, you know, that's a, what's the word? That's a habit. And it reads, to those, it's like a, to do those things which are not convenient or seemly, man. You know, being filled with all unrighteousness, fornication, which fornication is when you worship these other gods, man, being in these all types of philosophies. You know what I'm saying? You're a fornicator, man. You know, fornication also goes into adultery as well. And our people are doing that spiritually and physically. And there is wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, which is jealousy, murder, debate, or strife, deceit, malignity, whisperers, backbiters, haters of the Most High, despiteful, which means insolent, proud, boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedient to parents. Now, who are spiritual parents? The apostles and the elders, the great millstone, man. And the majority of our people can't see that because the Lord blinded them to receive it, man. You know? So, yeah. So now we're going to go to the book of St. John, the 12th chapter and the 40th verse. And it reads, verse 30. I'm going to start at verse 39. Therefore, they cannot believe because that Isaiah said again, he had blinded their eyes and hardened their hearts, which the word heart go back to the Hebrew word lot, which means a mind, right? That they should not see with their eyes, nor understand with their hear, with their heart, and could be and be converted, which meaning con meaning with, vert meaning truth, you know. And it reads, and I should heal them. Exactly, see, because the Lord ain't dealing with them, man. You know? Only way how you can be healed is if the Lord has lifted up that veil from your eyes, man. That veil from your eyes. You know, and come in and acknowledge this truth. You know, because this truth is what healed us, man. Through the spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahushai, by receiving the understanding of the word. You know, which is the fear of the Lord, which is the beginning of knowledge, right? You know? The fear of Yahweh Shem Yahushai is the beginning of knowledge, as it say. Let's see. This is 2 Corinthians 4, verse 3. But if our gospel is hidden, it is hidden to them that are lost. Right. So if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost. Man, who are lost? The two-thirds of our people, man. And why are they lost? Because the Lord didn't open their eyes, man, to see the truth. You know, so therefore, they're just wandering. They're just going astray. They're everywhere. Verse 4. Whom the God of this world, which go back to the Greek word aion, which means an age or rulership, that's going into Esau, Edom, beginning with their elites, have blinded the minds of them who believe not, which is our people, least the most, least the light of the glorious gospel of Yahweh Shah, who is the image of the Most High, should shine upon them. Exactly. And what's that light? That light represents this truth, man. So unless they pretty much be converted and repent and accept this truth, man, you know, the good news, the gospel, you know, hey, Yahweh Shem Yahushua is going to leave you in darkness, and then the Lord is going to destroy you, man. Simple and plain. You know, I got one more precept and I'm going to close it out. This is the book of Wisdom of Solomon, the 6th chapter and the 12th verse. Wisdom is glorious and never fadeth away. Yea, she is easily seen to them that love her and found of such as seek her. Exactly. See, she is easily seen of them that love her. So what's the love according to the Bible? Keeping the law, statutes, and commandments to the best of our abilities, right? And one of the laws is calling upon the right name of Yahweh Shem Yahushua, you know? So we can easily see this truth because the Lord is dealing with us. But those who can't understand, man, they're wicked. You know, none of the wicked shall understand the truth because the Lord blinded them. You know. So write the scripture right here in Wisdom of Solomon, the 6th chapter, is referring to the elect on this particular verse, you know, on down. So, hey, with that, Lord, with this video is edifying. Till next time, I say Shalom.